The old stories tell of the great forces of nature, of the tides and heavenly bodies that control our destiny. Uncontrollable, all-powerful. They also tell of us human beings at their mercy. But while the old stories were being told, human history continued. There were groundbreaking inventions. The Industrial Revolution. Many people were now living better lives. And suddenly, there is a new story. The story of humankind, which has itself become a shaping force in the Earth system and is redrawing the face of the Earth. The age of humans has begun. Welcome to the Anthropocene. About half of the Earth's land surface has been altered by people. We're burning more oil, gas, and coal today than ever before. As a result, CO2 is accumulating in the Earth's atmosphere and changing the climate. The CO2 is also dissolving in the oceans, making them more acidic. Other waste products are accumulating in the sea too. And at the same time, we're fishing so much that many fish stocks are under threat. We're degrading soils, cutting down forests, sealing surfaces. We're rampantly wasting resources, even though we know we're causing the disappearance of many species, even entire ecosystems. These global environmental changes involve considerable risks for ourselves. For example, climate change intensifies heat waves, droughts, and extreme precipitation. The rise in sea levels threatens people who live on coasts or islands, and the loss of soils jeopardizes harvests, and therefore the very survival of many. In short, up to now, we have evidently not made optimum use of our new power in this new age of humans. But how can we make positive use of our newfound power? How can we make global development possible without compromising our natural life support systems? These are some of the questions being asked by the German Advisory Council on Global Change, or WBGU. What forms of damage must we avoid at all costs in order not to threaten humankind's natural life support systems? The WBGU has defined planetary guardrails, which help to keep such existential damage at bay. For example, to avoid dangerous changes in the climate, we should limit global warming to less than 2 degrees compared to the pre-industrialization period. This does not mean that catastrophic events are immediately to be expected if global warming reaches 2.1 degrees, but we can expect growing hazards for humankind as the temperature rises. Similar guardrails have also been defined for ocean acidification, land use, biodiversity, and other environmental areas. Planetary guardrails thus give scientifically based assessments of the paths along which we can develop in the future, how we can live well without accidentally abolishing ourselves. In order to develop within these guardrails, we must change our way of doing business. The way we generate energy, for example, how we use the land or build our cities. This is the task of policymakers. We must hold them accountable. But it is also the responsibility of every individual. There are many people who are already showing us how it is done. We can tell a new story because we have the power to change direction before it is too late. Science calls this the transformation towards sustainability. And guardrails provide the framework within which we can shape this transformation.